Hi, before anything else, I was able to tap into some sort of free energy. For years and years, people had this notion of a universal energy flowing through the entire cosmos, one that engulfs us all. This free-flowing energy is emphasized through cosmic bodies, such as suns or planets. Our planet Earth is the perfect embodiment of this pure energy. The existence and use of this energy has always been communicated to us by the ancient aliens to our ancestors, who are shown as gods in old illustrations. Alas, our fathers were not advanced enough to use such knowledge. Or were they? Evidence shows ancient Egyptians built huge pyramids to align with stars, specifically to channel energy through carefully placed vent holes of the Great Pyramid. The energy filled the main chamber, and the harvested power was stored in large batteries imported from the ancient city of Baghdad, or what we call Baghdad batteries. Earth had become a hub for ancient aliens to fuel up their ships on the stored energy in those batteries. Here an alien is shown with a dog head which served as his helmet. Alien is paying humans in gems to purchase Baghdad battery. Similar energy factories were found in ancient Mayan civilizations, who also created the most accurate calendar predicting even the future. These factories were built on lands with strongest energy pockets. I discovered one of these energy pockets in my own room, and all it takes to harvest it is a few turns of ordinary wire like this, and it can turn on an LED. All we need is a way to detect these energy pockets and solve world's energy crisis altogether. Bullshit! God, I haven't served so much shit in one session. I feel dirty as f. The so-called energy pocket is created by this induction cooktop. Okay, let's calm down. See, with the protection they put in this thingy, I can't turn it on unless I put an iron plate on it, and the plate gets very hot very quickly, so it's a bit dangerous. I will probably design my own induction heater later with no safety features, but for now, let's experiment with this. See, if I try to turn on the power, it gives me an error until I put the metal plate on, and then it turns on. You can hear the metal plate vibrating because of the vibrating magnetic fields. I can push this further to the side so that some of the magnetic field can leak from the side, and I can turn on my LED with it. These fields are generally safe to touch, but they mess with my light's electronics. It's funny though, it seems like my LED turns on one way and not the other. I assumed the magnetic fields coming out of this are symmetrical, so it wouldn't matter. I made a single loop on my scope probe so it can pick up the fields coming from the cooker. Oh, it looks like a half wave rather than a full wave at a frequency of around 20 kHz. It heats things up just fine, so it's not broken. Anyways, the asymmetrical waveform results in a higher positive voltage on one side and smaller negative voltage on the other side. And that's why my LED works in the direction that gives a larger positive voltage across it. And yes, I'll give away two more of these great Keysight scopes at the end of the video. Also search for Keysight Wave 2018. How does the induction cooker work? Simple. There is a large inductor coil in there, and the driver circuit sends a very high AC current through it that generates large oscillating magnetic fields. The coil itself is very low resistance and doesn't generate the heat and stays cool. When a metal pot is placed on top of the coil, the high oscillating magnetic fields passing through the metal pot generate very high eddy currents, and those currents passing through the resistance of the pot generate heat. But if the pot is made of aluminum or copper, it doesn't generate significant heat because the resistance is very small and the power converted into thermal energy is equal to resistance times current squared. But if the pot is made of cast iron or ferromagnetic steel, because its resistance is much higher than aluminum or copper, it heats up much more. And also, because iron is ferromagnetic, the AC current runs much closer to the surface of the conductor due to something called skin effect, and that further increases the resistance. Why does skin effect increases resistance? Simple. Assume a cross-section of a wire. The AC current, instead of passing through the entire cross-section, only passes through a shallow depth of the conductor due to the skin effect at higher frequency. And that's like having a thinner wire with higher resistance. You can see in this pot, they put a dedicated plate on the bottom to make it work with the induction cooker. The benefit of induction cooker is that, unlike the electrical heater or gas cooker that a lot of heat can escape around the pot and is wasted, in induction cooker the pot itself heats up. So it's much more efficient and it heats up much faster. So the natural next step is, can it charge my cell phone? My phone comes with this integrated wireless charger, so maybe I should drop it on. Although those work at a much higher frequency, and if the battery heats up it could explode. No. All I really need is a bunch of wire turns to pick up the voltage like a transformer and then convert the voltage to a proper level using one of these USB car chargers. Do you guys remember the video of that guy making a mobile phone battery pack charger using 9-volt battery and circuit from USB car charger?
So now be careful, fold the wires, keep it open, and then I'm gonna plug it in and boom.
Well, that's totally correct. You just connect the battery positive to the center tap and the battery negative to the side tap and it starts charging your phone. The issue is that the regular 9-volt battery is a piece of junk and can at best charge the phone to around 10 to 20%. Buying one of those commercial battery packs is much better. But I guess you could use it in case of an emergency. Now I just connect my winding to the charger and see if it can turn its LED on. Not really, maybe it's off. What you shouldn't forget is that the output of a transformer is AC and the negative voltage would break your circuit. So you would need a full bridge rectifier. Or here, a single diode would work too, because the power is low and the frequency is high. Good thing I bought two of these. I connected the diode here. Let's try it. It's charging. Who needs those pesky charging pads now? Now, can I turn on a lamp with it? I saw the video of this guy pulling energy from his induction cooker and turning lamps on, which could totally work. But why the f*** did he call it free energy? Did he plug his cooker into his neighbor's outlet? Anyway, we need many more turns to get high enough voltage. And here is my handicraft. Let's measure and see where we are. It's higher. Well, I'm measuring peaks close to 100 volts, but they are like half sine wave with a strange waveform. So it's not powerful enough. Well, it can hardly turn on a 60 watt lamp. See? I don't know if it's even visible. But the LED lights require less power, so maybe that can turn on. Hey, look at that. Sort of turning on blinking. Obviously, we need more voltage. I made a diode capacitor to rectify the voltage and hopefully get more power out of it. I'm measuring the capacitor voltage and it's around More than the capacitor can take. I can do more winding. Here we are, a much larger coil, and I have also connected a 60 watt and a 150 watt incandescent light in parallel to the coil, and I'm also measuring the voltage. Let's see. It's working. Oh, for some reason the voltage is rising to 200 volt AC and dropping. But hey, it's working. The cool part is that the coil itself is not warm at all. And you know what it means? I can connect the power plug of the cooker to my coil and put it there so that the energy from the coil goes back and turns on the cooker. Free energy.
Give away time.
All hail to Keysight. They are fulfilling my dream that every household should have a great oscilloscope. And make sure to go to Keysight Wave 2018 and register for huge oscilloscope giveaways. And as usual, for my two giveaways, my patrons at patreon.com are automatically in the draw. For everyone else, please subscribe to Keysight Labs channel and also go to the Google form I provided in description and say yes if you want the scope or no if you enjoy filling forms.